Greetings. I am the summoner Yuna. I have come from the temple in Bisade.
Oh, Milady Summoner!
If there is no other summoner here, please allow me to perform the sending.
Ah, thanks, BT.
Our loved ones. We feared they would become fiends.
Please, take me to them.
We'll go see what we can do to help in town.
Huh? Hey guys, this is Zazaleto, and welcome back to Final Fantasy X. Last time, we watched Sin utterly destroy Kilika Port. This time, we're gonna go see what we can do to help. Not after we level up everyone first, though. Yeah, I'm a dick. We're gonna move Lulu. Ah, she only can move back to there. She can't move, like... that's kinda lame, but oh well. Lily Kira can move forward. No. I'm glad it gives you that option. I want to move right here. Yes. And use an ability sphere and unlock the ability Lancet. And look at that. Kimari and Lily Kira are literally right next to each other. Everyone's really close to each other. I just realized how close they all are. That's pretty interesting. Locke can keep moving over this way. And use a mana sphere to get some MP, which he needs because he has a very low mana pool. Yuna, we're gonna have you move down here. Can't learn anything yet, unfortunately. Kimari, having someone else with scan would be nice too. So I'm gonna have him learn scan. I think I might make him double back though and go the other way. Or maybe go even into Ulikura's pool, perhaps. I mean, really, Kimari can kinda go anywhere except for that way, of course, but. Yeah. Lulu, okay. Looks like we used everyone's skill point. Yes. Alrighty, we're gonna go ahead and save. Let's go see if we can't do anything to help out Kilika Port. Looks like they're already repairing stuff over here. Let's talk to Waka. Oop. Alrighty. Guess we can't talk to Waka. How about you then? Nope. What's everyone over here doing? Oh, here's Kimari. Is Yuna nearby then? Yep, there she is.
What's ascending? Are we going somewhere?
You truly are clueless. Are you sure it's just your memory that's the problem? The dead need guidance. Filled with grief over their own death, they refuse to face their fate. They yearn to live on and resent those still alive. You see, they envy the living. And in time, that envy turns to anger, even hate. Should these souls remain in Spira, they become fiends that prey on the living. Sad, isn't it? The sending takes them to the far plane, where they may rest in peace.
Summoners do this?
Thank you.
that cutscene needs no words because it's easily one of the prettiest in the game. Ugh, bit spine chilling about when you think about it.
It must be tough, being a summoner.
Yuna chose her own path. She knew from the beginning what it meant. All we can do is protect her along the way, until the end.
Until the end? What's the end?
Until she defeats Sin.
How is he supposed to know, man? He's from a thousand years in the past.
I hope I did okay.
You did very well. They've reached the far plane by now, but no tears next time,
I wished there would never be a next time. No more people being killed by Sin. No more sendings for Yuna. Everyone stood there watching her. It was strange, and somehow, horrifying. I never wanted to see it again.
That's probably honestly a good review of the sending. It's amazing and enchanting, but terrifying when you think about it. That cutscene always gives me shivers when I see it because it's just so good. And nothing good there. Hello. Oh, the others left some time ago? Sounds like a good excuse for me to save!
Hey, you awake? Captain Walker's waiting for you.
Oh, thank you, Dotto. Where's he waiting at? This way? Oh, looks like I can't go this way. Yeah. Probably can't go into that house either. Watch, this guy's gonna stop me. Oh, no, never mind. Okay, I can go in here. Anything good in here? Nope, just people. That's not interesting at all. Guess we gotta go this way for Captain Waka. Oh, can we go in here? And there's Waka over there. We'll go get to you. Oh! Very worth it. T's or D's, awesome. We already found the first four books of the alphabet primer, nice. Looks like that guy got in there and got his booze after all.
Ah, there you are. Be safe, Aurochs, huddle. On to the temple, where we pray for victory.
Go!
High Summoner O'Holland used to live in the Kilika Temple here. Yep. Lord O'Holland was once a great blitzer, you know?
Waka.
Hmm?
Praying for victories, all good. But is this right?
Something wrong with enjoying blitzball?
Is this really the time?
This is the only time. The players fight with all their strength. The fans cheer for their favorite team. They forget pain, suffering. Only the game matters. That's why Blitz has been around for so long. At least that's what I think.
Whatever you say.
Let's play and win, right?
Right.
Temple's beyond the jungle there. Let's go.
Ah, beyond the jungle. That means enemies! Is there anything I can get over here? Yes, there is, ha! Oh, it's a cell. Ooh! Well, I already have a Rod of Wisdom. Ooh. Oh! That shows me what I have equipped up at the top. So this gives me sensor, that gives me sensor, this gives me sensor, that gives me sensor, and look, more sensor. Okay. So that's for Ulikira. That's for Yuna. I might as well buy that. Yes, go ahead and equip it. That's for Waka. Oh, I didn't equip it though. And one for Kimari. And, oh, Lulu has a bangle equipped, but it doesn't have HP plus 5, so we'll go ahead and do that. Do I want to buy these though? Sensor's really nice to have. And it, actually, the weapons don't change stats unless if they have a bonus specifically like that. But I still don't know what distill speed means. Yeah, the Rod of Wisdom I currently have is much better. Magic plus 8% and sensor. Too good. Oh. Oh, Kimari's Hunter Spear already has sensor and piercing. That's good to know. So that means Kimari and Yuna both can sensor people when they're out. That's good. No, I don't want to buy anything else. Eh. So I can't get to the chest itself. That kind of sucks. Oh, but I want to go ahead and equip that thing to Waka that I didn't equip, because I'm dumb. Is there anything else I can get over here, maybe? Potentially? Oh, that guy got affected by Sin's toxins. Alrighty then, guess we're done here for now. Let's head out to the jungle and head to the temple then. Where, of course, we'll probably be fighting stuff. Because that's how this game is. Can I switch? Oh, yes, good, I can switch people around here. Bleak here in the front. We'll use Yuna and Kimari some. I believe everyone gets AP regardless of who's used, so it doesn't matter if you want to stick to specific people. But I like to give everyone a little bit of screen time. And we got a save sphere, so might as well use it.
What's up?
Yuna's saying she wants you with us.
Huh?
I want to ask you to be my guardian.
You know what? There's no time for jokes, yeah? He may be a blitzball whiz kid, but up against fiends, he's a newbie.
Not a guardian, then. I just want him nearby.
What?
What?
I forgot how good that feels.
It's just that... Well...
We're all going to the temple anyway. Can't this wait till later?
Thank you, Lulu, for distilling that.
I shouldn't have...
There's nothing to be sorry about. I'm just not really sure what's going on.
My apologies.
Exactly, Kimari. Exactly. Ooh, what do we have here? We can understand the sea, but that's about it. Oh. Look, a monster's up ahead, guys. Who would have thought? But we're gonna go down these side paths first and see what's up. Cause there's treasure! Hey, some monospheres, nice. I think I have lots of those, actually. Yep, and of course we got some fighting against some new enemies. Ow! Oh, he missed. Good.
Kimari, why don't you use Lancet on it?
What's a Lancet?
Normally, it's a skill that weakens enemies and heals the user. But when a Ronso uses it, that Ronso can sometimes learn fiend's abilities.
Hey, sounds cool.
Yeah, we get into Lancet. Oh, and now we can see even more thanks to the sensor on Kimari. This guy's weak to fire, and he's got an HP of only 520. And now Kimari knows Seed Cannon. Yeah, Kimari's pretty badass, honestly. He's like a blue mage of sorts. Oh, and I might as well show this. Lulu's regular attack. Attack, plushie! Yeah, I like that animation. It's funny. Ooh, we got Kimari's ability here. Yeah, see, jump was his special, but also now he has seed cannon. Bam. Have a taste of your own medicine. And even now, even Ulikura knows Lancet, so we can use it to heal himself anytime he wants, even though it's kind of weak for Ulikura. Obviously, it's a much better skill for Kimari, because he can learn abilities through it. So using Kimari's Lancet on whatever we find is might prove... Oh, I guess only the people in battle do get level up, so I will be switching them out quite often. Likira can't learn a skill off either one of those. Oh, the scan just automatically display the stuff? So it's a passive ability, I get you. Abilities with this H-like symbol are ones you use in battles. Ones like this are passive abilities, so whenever Kimari's out, he just automatically has sensor going. That's pretty good. Who else had a level up? Lulu! We want to move you down here, because there's an MP gain here. And that's all, ooh, wow. By 20, that's a huge gain for Lulu, holy cow. And I think anytime one of my guys levels up, I'm gonna go ahead and swap him out with someone else. Just to keep everyone leveling up. I know it's not the ideal thing to do, but it's what I'm gonna do. Oh, we got some interesting enemies here this time. We got a Deioxys, which is weak to... looks like lightning, but he takes half damage from fire. A Killer Bee, which is weak to whatever the... oh, the white is ice. Okay, so this elemental is weak to water. He heals from electricity and takes half damage from fire and water. Or fire and ice. So this guy's weak to ice then, and this one's weak to ice as well. So ice is what our key ability is for this one. Summon Kira. Extract ability. Make one enemy drop ability spheres. That's alright. Honestly, Yuna's kind of useless here right now. Let's just try and get an ability sphere from something. Because I'm pretty low on those, and having those would be nice. Unfortunately, Yuna's kind of weak in the health department.
Man, blows can't hurt it, huh?
Oh, okay. Nope, never mind. I guess... huh. I guess just because... oh, maybe because Yuna and Kimari both have sensor abilities, it just helps me... you know... identify them all the more better, I guess, would be the term. I don't know. Anyways, use Lancet on this guy. Maybe we can learn something. Nope, nothing. Damn. Yeah, that guy in the middle is gonna be annoying because he's an elemental. And that's gonna hurt. Yuna. Oh, no. That's not what I wanted to do.
Newbie here.
Sorry.
I wanted to swap out Lulu. Because he is weak to water, as an electric animal.
Anyone
elemental.
Thirsty?
And he's down. This is now a much more favorable fight. I'm gonna switch out Yuna for Kimari. Just because I want to see if I can't learn anything off that guy. Nope. Aw, that sucks. This guy's going next. Kill him. And let's go ahead and just show off scan and show you what it's like. See, so now you can see absolutely everything about this enemy. Strength 14, magic 1. He doesn't have any immunities. He takes half damage from fire, but he's very weak to ice. Very nimble and hard to hit. Magic defense is also high. Defeat it quickly to avoid damage. Vulnerable to ice. And now see, whenever you look at it, we'll be able to see that data even without the scan, without sensor on our weapons. So it's very useful to just scan everything you see, really.
Please.
That's why I want to get scan onto as many people as I can early on. Having all that information is very useful. And we got several more level ups. So let's go ahead and use the sphere grid. Waka. Unfortunately, it doesn't look like you can use anything useful here. What did we go? Silence Sack or Guard? What's later on down this way? Power Break. Power Break would be pretty useful. Extract Power, ooh. Haste, that's very useful as well. Is that on Lulu's path? No, it's way far away from her, that's interesting. If Ulikira kept going up, he would have easily been able to get to Haste. people will unlock there, so we'd have to go this way for aim. Aim would be really useful for Waka, actually. Lulu. Down here and use a monosphere to get magic defense plus 3. Alrighty. Kimari can move. I'm gonna move him back this way. Actually, what does he get? Extract ability? Oh, he goes into the way that Yuna was going, but Yuna's going down that way. Would that be worth it? I don't know how much mana Kimari has, so go for magic abilities might not be the best idea. Yeah, we're just gonna move Kimari back. Kind of a waste, but it's alright. And now we can use Yuna's ability sphere to get No Blaze! That's gonna be useful. Kira. Alrighty. Level ups on everyone but really curious. Let's throw him in somewhere. Who do I wanna change out? I wanna keep Kimari in because he'll be useful for trying to learn stuff this early on. So we'll switch out Waka and him. I'm gonna use potions on these guys, though, to heal them up real quick. Anything over this way? A bridge! Oh. Oh, the Crusaders are here. Interesting. Let's see where they're going. Oh. Well, it's a good thing I kept Lulu in. Cheer!
Let's give them all we got!
I already used Lancet on the bee, but I haven't tried it on this guy yet. Ooh, wow, those guys have a ton of mana I can steal from. That's useful to know. Let's go ahead and take that guy out early, so he doesn't cause too many issues. It's kind of cool, because you can also notice that the equipment on them changes whenever you equip something new. It's always those little touches that are nice. And, Ulikira's poison.
Waka's in charge of flyers, remember?
Kimari's turn. Just kill him. Or not. Ah, Lulu's poisoned too now. God damn it. Oh, he's worked weak to ice, not fire. Whoops. But I still got the overkill. Alrighty. That poison damage. And I believe poison persists after battle, so healing them up after the fight will be very useful. Oh, never mind, I guess it doesn't. Jeez, that's a big world map. Well, let's go ahead and heal people up real quick, and we're good. As you can probably guess, we'll probably be coming back to the item sphere, the sphere grid, quite often. Okay, you got Ulikira. That now, Lulu can move. Can't get anything off that level up, but that's alright. Formation, swap in Yuna for. Oh, not Kimari. Yuna for Lulu and Waka for Lulu. Anything this way? It's always worthwhile to look around, see what you can find. I could summon Kira, but it's not really worth it. No one needs to be cured, healed. Let's just try and extract an ability sphere then. Waka, the flying guy's yours. Yeah, nice. Ah. I already scanned him, so there's no point. An easy kill. Oh, Yuna got another level up. And she learns Null Shock. Nice. Oh, what's this ability in the middle? Oh, life! Oh, we definitely want her to learn that. We need to get to that ability ASAP. Life is gonna be very useful. Because as the name provides, it restores a party member from death. Ow. Ow. Well, finally we can make some use of Yuna using her white magic.
Aid us.
Uh, I kind of don't want to kill that purely because I want Kimari to scan it, so.
Man, look.
Yeah, we know, Waka. Go ahead and scan this dude. See here, we got Killer Bee, aerial and hard to hit. Use Waka's attack to knock it down. It's vulnerable ice, so blizzards is also effective. Attacks may inflict poison, that's good to know. That it can just sometimes poison. Ow. Okay, Yuna needs to heal herself. Thank God she has shit tons of MP. Oh, wow, Kimari has a lot of MP too. So actually, Kimari learning black magic would be very useful. Go ahead and peg this guy down. Overkill much. Doesn't scan the elemental. Yeah, you better get used to me scanning, because I do it a lot. I like to know what everything's weak to. It's very useful. It's immune to nearly everything. Interesting, it's not immune to instant KO moves, though. Swap out for Lulu. Just so we can get the easy kill on this guy. And there we go. Waka and Kimari get level ups. And doing all these random battles is quite good because, as you see, we get lots and lots of money from it, too. Waka, we want you to go. If I go for guard, there's probably more defensive skills over here for him. But if I go down here, I can get sleep attack. I think I'll do that. Or silence attack, yeah, silence attack will be very useful. And Kimari got the other one. Gonna use an ability sphere, so now even Kimari can blind people. We're also gonna use a power sphere down here for defense up. Unfortunately, we're out of ability spheres though, which sucks. That's alright. We'll make do with what we got. Also, there was that one enemy in the road back there. I think I'm gonna double back and go get it real quick. Ah, this dude. Kinda makes me wonder if I use Lancet on it. Nah, that would've been cool though. I need to get Yuna over there to learn black magic, because that'd be nice. Ow. You're weak to fire, yes? Yes. Burn. Wow, it didn't die. How much HP does it have? Oh, a lot more than I thought it did. Damn. Extract more ability orbs. Spheres. Whatever. Ow. Okay, we need to heal Lulikira. He's taking one too many hits. Hey, there we go. Took that dude out. I'm debating now whether or not I should show all this on screen. I don't know. It is a bit tedious, but at the same time, it's probably good to know what I'm leveling up my guys into so you guys can see it. And then, think after Yuna learns this, I can double back all the way over to here and bring her over into Lulu's tree to learn the black magic, possibly. But that's one, two, at least three level ups to be able to start learning black magic. Would that be worth it? It'd take me a lot longer to get to life after that. Decisions, decisions. Ah, I'm still not used to this button scheme, apparently. Go figure. Let's keep going this way. Oh, I thought there was an enemy in the way, but I guess not. But there seems to be a chest over here! That's always nice. A Lux Sphere, ooh! Those are a bit rarer than the other spheres, I believe. Mostly because Lux is not that common on the sphere grid. Okay, it's tight. I already scanned all three of them, I think, before, right? Yeah. All of them, I should say. Just attack him then. Hey, we got him. Good. Go ahead and use Null Shock.
Thunderous Bane.
Which won't really matter much because I'm just gonna kill it in one hit with water anyways, I think. Oh yeah, with an overkill, definitely. And now we're starting to get more into the meat and potatoes of this game, where we're going to be battling a lot. But that's alright. Hi there. Oh, that's what that does. I don't have a Lux Sphere, though. I kind of wasted that, I feel like. But at the same time, that means that anyone else can use that Luck Node now. And a lot of people start out in this general area, so that's not the worst thing? Question mark? Let's heal everyone up first and swap some people out. Really, Kira just leveled up, so let's put Kimari in. And we'll go fight this guy. How did we get on the other side of him? Hacks! Let's fight this boss, dude, and see what's up. He's weak to fire. I don't know what sort of abilities he uses, but let's just do that first on him. Because if I can, I want to try and get as many abilities to use as I can. Skill. He can dark attack now. He can glance it, which I might want to do. But first, let's scan him and see what's up. What do we got here? Lord Ochu. Ooh. He's pretty strong, has magical abilities, maybe. Claws inflict poison, restores lots of HP by sleeping, retaliates with earthquake if awakened, so watch out. Ooh. Being a plant, it burns easy. So we don't want to attack him when he's sleeping. Good to know. Oh, Distill Ability was on him because of what I used before. That means that Distill Speed means that when Lulu attacks people, she just has a chance to put Distill Speed on them, meaning we'll get more Speed Orbs. Interesting. I'm gonna go ahead and Isuna that poison off you real quick, Lulu. Having Yuna for this fight is gonna be very useful, but also very annoying. Lancet, Lord Ochu. Maybe I can learn something? No? Darn, that sucks. Go ahead and Isuna yourself, Yuna. Lulu's kinda low on HP, I might want to heal her on Yuna's next turn. I already scanned it, no point in doing that. Dark attack, actually. If we can blind him, that would be nice. Ah, he's immune, damn it. Ooh, okay, we might want to heal Yuna now. I'm gonna potion Lulu this turn on her turn, and Yuna's got her turn next, right? Yeah, she can heal herself easily. And Kira does a lot more healing than potions will. Since he's immune to darkness, just attack him, Kimari. Well, it's a good thing I got Yuna here. Now, Lulu's got her turn before him, so she'll be fine. Can go ahead and potion herself up. Yes, take it right out of your cleavage, Lulu. That's fine. Also, he used water. No water might be good to use on our team, then. Letting him restore HP like that would be bad. That's a lot that he restores, damn. I'm gonna go ahead and use a Null Tide, then, since I know he used water. It won't protect us from the earthquake that happens when he wakes up, but that's alright. I'd much rather him not be healing HP. So get up! Oh, he didn't wake up, though. Dang, he sleeps even though he's at half HP? Holy cow. Wake up. Oof, that did some good damage to everyone. And Kimari's almost dead. And Kimari is poisoned. And now he's back up. That's good. Lulu, go ahead and antidote him. Oh good, and Yuna's gonna have her turn before. And so that way she can heal Lulu up. Actually summon Kira. Things are getting a bit desperate. I think it calls for it. Lord Ochu is not one to be trifled with, apparently. And I'm pretty sure Kira can probably do a lot more damage than we can. Especially, actually, since it has Blaze, or Fire as well, so yeah. Blaze. I'm still in a Shining Force mood, apparently. No, we're playing Final Fantasy, you idiot. These are different rules. Ow, that hurt. Sonic Wings, how much does this do? A decent amount, wow. Immune to poison, that's good. Nice. And we get another turn, so we can blaze again. Blaze. Fire! We're playing Final Fantasy Zazaleto. It is fire now. We got the overdrive, take it out, Kira. Oh, that didn't kill it? Oh, no! Well, that's not terrible. If Kira dies, it just means it goes down essentially on a cooldown, so we won't be able to summon Kira for a while. But that's alright. Lord Ochu should be low enough that we can take it out now, right? Oh, yeah, it's plenty low enough. And I missed. That's alright. Lulu should be able to take him out with a fire. Yeah! Ooh, a variable mog.
A summoner and her guardians. Very impressive.
Sir, we should fight too.
We'll get our chance soon enough.
Young crusaders gather around. We'll be sending to the ground.
Well, alrighty then. We defeated Lord Ochu and our way's a bit clearer, even though we could have just went around him. And we're going to be continuing next time. Sorry this episode went a bit long, guys, but that's alright. I think you'll enjoy me derping around and fighting anyways. So, I guess I'll see you guys next time for more Final Fantasy X. See you later!